Hi guys, this is Soibal and I will discuss basic things of electrical circuit, like what is charge, what is voltage and what is current and etc. So let's start. What is charge? Actually, charge is an electrical property of the atomic particle of which matter consists, and it measures in coulombs and it denoted by capital C. So the coulomb is actually a large unit for charge. If 1 coulomb of charge, there are actually 1 by 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹, which is means 6.24 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons. So in laboratory case, the charge in form of picocoulomb or microcoulomb or nanocoulomb. Now go to the electrical current or electric current. What is electrical current? Electric current. So it is nothing but the time rate of change of charge. So at a glance, the electric charge is the time rate of change of charge, and it measure in ampere, so denoted it A. So its mathematical expression is I equal to dq by dt. So that means the time rate of change with the charge. So its unit is ampere. So by using this, we can also derive that q equal to charge equal to T0 by Tf t or Tf equal to I into dt. So this is the current. Now we can also say that this is current is direct current or alternating current. So let's start. What do you mean by DC or direct current? Direct current is a current that remains constant with time. So if we changing the time, the current rate does not change. That means, so the waveform, if we considering waveform, that it, if x axis denoted t and y axis denoted I, then it means this waveform is constant. So if we increase the or vary the time, the current will be not change. That means this is the DC current. And if we consider another current, that is alternating current. Alternating current is current that varies sinusoidally with time. So this is the basic difference in between the AC and DC. The we plot the graph that it is, if it is x axis it gives t, y axis I. So this is the waveform sinusoidally change with respect to time. This is the waveform. So now start about the direction of current. So in conventional law, if we consider that current is flow like this, so this is the positive current flow. Like if we consider this is 5 ampere, if we current is flow from this direction, this is minus 5 ampere DC direction. You can also consider it your own. If you consider that as a minus and this is positive, this also consider, but you have to remember consider this thing in all during the all the solving of the equation. So you must be remember, otherwise you can follow this conventional law. When this is direction, this is positive, and when this is backward, this is minus 5. Now come to the voltage. What is voltage? Voltage is the energy required to move a unit charge through an element. that is voltage. So voltage is also called potential difference. So in mathematical expression, we can easily find, if we determine the potential or voltage in between two points, so VAB is defined as the change in to move a unit charge, is defined as the energy required to move a unit charge through an element. So this is the dW by dQ, where W is the energy and Q is the charge. Now consider that, this is load plus A and plus B minus. So here the voltage difference will be VAB. So this figure shows the voltage across an element connected to the point A and B, and the plus and minus are used to define reference direction or voltage polarity. The VAB can be interpreted in two ways. One is, if point A is at potential of AB, voltage higher than the point B. This is one interpretation. And another is, we can say the potential at point A with respect to point B is VAB. This also right. And it follows logically, the general, we can write VAB also V equal minus VA. This also can write. Now consider one example. So consider this one A B plus minus 9 volt. So here we consider two example. We have two representation of the same voltage. Now in first case, the point A is 9 volt above point B, or in second case, point B is minus 9 volt above point A. Now we may also say that from figure first, that there is a 9 volt voltage drop from A to B, or equivalently A 9 voltage rise from B to A. It also can say, in other words, a voltage drop from A to B is equivalent to a voltage rise from B to A. So this is the general representation of the voltage. Now we consider power. So what is power? Power is the time rate of expending on absorbing energy, that is P equal to dW by dt. That's the power, or it measure in the omega watt. So we can easily rewrite power, that dW by dt, we can split up dW by dq and dq by dt, where dW or dt, we previously seen dt is the voltage and dq by dt which is current. So power is nothing but the multiplication of the voltage and current. So here the power is called instantaneous power. Now we go for, when we easily determine that it is a absorbing process or delivering process, we have to see by using direction of the current. Let's consider one example. We consider another example. So in sine conversion, when the current enters through the positive terminal of the element, then P equal to VI, which means is greater than 0, that the element is absorbing power. In another case, when the current enters through the negative terminal, then P equal to minus VI, which less than equal to 0, and it means it supplying or release power. So let's start with one example. That here it you see that the current is entering from positive terminal, so here P equal to positive means 3 into 4 equal to by 12 volt, so it means it absorbing power. In same case, you see that the current is entering from the positive terminal, go through the negative terminal, that's why it also this is positive. And now let use one another example where the current enters through the negative terminal. So if we consider one example that this plus minus 4 volt and current 3 ampere. So you see that the current is entering from negative terminal here and goes on the positive. So here the P equal to minus VI. So here the power is supplying or release. So you have to remember two things, that when the current enters through the positive terminal, then P equal to plus VI, and if the current enters through the negative terminal, you have to remember the power will be negative VI. Now we consider what is energy. Energy is the capacity to do work, and it's measured in joule. So we can write expression omega equal to T0 T P and DT, where P is the power. We can also write T0 to T, this is VI DT. So today we will basically discuss about the basic things like what is charge, what is current, what is voltage, what is power and what is energy, and its respective equation. And this equation is most important for doing like circuit analysis or anything. This is the basic thing. You have to remember that P equal to d omega by dt and P equal to VI, when the power is positive, when the power is negative, you have to remember the sign. It's very, very, very important. So that's it. Thank you for your attention. If you have any query, please comment on the video section. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.